In this example, we're going to use a system of equations to find how many dimes and quarters a person has if she has 21 coins worth a total of $3.45. So you're always looking at the question to see what you're going to set your variables up as. And it's asking how many of each type of coin. So one, we want to find the number of each type of coin. So we're going to say that dimes is D and quarters is Q, just to set that up so we know what our unknowns are. Then we're going to see that we have 21 coins, and we're going to count those with our first equation. So counting the coins is just going to be your dimes plus your quarters is going to be 21 coins. So D plus Q equals 21. Simple enough. The other piece of information that they've given us is that the total is $3.45. So the second equation is going to add your money. And you're going to think, how many, what's the worth of each dime? It's 10 cents, so you're going to put 0.10D. A quarter is 25 cents, so you're going to put plus 20.25Q. And your total money is $3.45. So the second equation is putting money in at each position. Money on the dimes, money on the quarters, and then total money on the end. Then what we're going to do is we've got our system, D plus Q equals 21, and the 10 cents D, 25 cents Q is $3.45. Whenever you have decimals in your system, it's an easy fix to just multiply by 100, and when you do that, you get to move the decimal to the right two places in each place. Make sure you do that all three places. So the second equation becomes 10D plus 25Q equals 345. Much easier numbers to work with. So you've got your D plus Q equals 21, and your 10D plus 25Q equals 345. We're going to make some opposites here. We're going to make the D's opposite, so we're going to swap the numbers. There's an imaginary 1 in front of the D, there's a on the top, and there's a 10 in front of the D on the bottom. So go ahead and swap those. And looking at that position, those are the same sign. Those are both positive, so we're going to make one of our outside numbers negative. And that's our setup. So now multiplying that negative 10 through the top equation gives you negative 10D minus 10Q equals negative 210. And then multiplying 1 on the bottom basically does not change that equation. So that bottom equation stays the same. Then you're going to add the equations together, and your D's will cancel, which is why we made those opposites. You're going to have a 15Q because negative 10 plus 25 is 15. And then negative 210 plus 345 is 135. As a final step, divide by 15. And you'll find that Q is equal to 9. And that is the number of quarters for this problem. Then you can just take the 9 and plug it anywhere you want. I'm going to take the original D plus Q and put the 9 in for Q. And then you're just subtracting the 9 from both sides and finding that D is equal to 12, and that's the number of dimes that we have. So to answer the question, it's 9 quarters and 12 dimes.